Well, I graduated from high school in 1942 and started college at Xavier University in the fall of 42 and finished the first year there in 43 and then enlisted in the Air Corps July of 1943 when the war was well underway. My first assignment was to Miami Beach. I looked forward to that because I had been there once previously as a youngster with my mother and dad, and I thought, oh boy, this would be a great assignment. Basic training at Miami Beach was not a great assignment. It was summertime, July, August, and September, and marching around with a rifle over my shoulder was not exactly my idea of what the Air Force should be all about. Anyway, eventually we finished basic training, went on from there to a brief stint at a college in Iowa, which was a little more training, then to a camp in Santa Ana, California, where we were divided up after a number of physical tests and written tests. And on the basis of that, we were appointed to certain training sites. So from California, our group that were destined to be navigators were shipped to Hondo, Texas, which was a small town, about 50 miles west of San Antonio. There we were trained in the field that we were supposed to perform. When we finished, I got my wings as a navigator and was commissioned second lieutenant. And from there, we were sent to Boca Raton, and we stayed in the Boca Raton Hotel. Now that we were commissioned officers, we could go off base. Every evening after our duty day hours were over with, we usually did the town at that time.
Well, good.
And following that was assigned to a field in Kansas where we were matched up with our crews, so that I was matched up with a crew of 10 other people, both officers and non-coms, and started training for our future as an active crew overseas. We trained on B-29s. Well, that was the largest bomber in the Second World War. It was designed to have a long range, could travel many miles without refueling, and had the capabilities of carrying a bomb load. As I recall, I think it was around 20,000 pounds that we would carry, but that was stretching it. That's why it was so important to us to have the Marines go into and secure Iwo Jima, so that if coming back from the target, we had a place that if we were running quite low on fuel, or if we were damaged from enemy action and not capable of making it all the way back to our home base, we could land there at Iwo Jima as an emergency. Well, I flew 18 missions, and the nature of the missions was most of our missions were made at night. That way, we had a little less combat with the Japanese fighter planes. We had to contend mostly with anti-aircraft fire. At least half of our missions were firebombing missions, where we would hit the targets just with the firebombs.
Tell us what a ground gripper was.
It was a slang term that the flying personnel applied to the officers that were non-flying Air Force personnel. I knew when the war ended that I didn't want to make a career out of the Air Force or the military in any way. So I decided I'd just return to my pre-med program. I decided to go to the University of Cincinnati then.